your black bag, Vikings! And woo! You can see all the players have put on garb for tonight's big event.
What do you mean?
I am now...
You keep knocking on the dice cam when you do.
I'm just gonna tell
oh,
you.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I'm gonna
I'm
tell
sorry.
You, I am full on a tunic guy now. Nick supplied us with these tunics.
Nick had crazy tunics for days, y'all.
Like, I'm never not wearing a tunic. I'm now the tunic guy.
All right.
Fair. Fair.
It's a good look.
My jaunty cap.
Sir, it's a tie only. I've got the tie. You're going to have to deal with the tunic.
Tie and tunic, right?
So welcome everybody to the game. We appreciate that you are here. Real quick before we jump into things, there is a special secret cool thing that can get unlocked. How does it work? Can a bunch of people jump in on it, or does one person?
Yeah. Anyone can jump in on it, but they can't donate to anything. The money has to go to that.
The money has to go to that one event. So we have one event that's planned that's up to the Elder Gods on whether or not they want to make it happen.
Is it me getting visited by Valkyries again?
Visited.
It might look like I've drank only had a beer, but it's a only fourth, like a sip.
He's had like a fourth of a beer, and he's already talking like this.
My page is a little wet.
It was my fault. I brought in a bunch of stuff. I was really rushed. I knocked over his beer.
I shot Nick in the eye, and then
if there's right. anything that deserves beer on the character sheet, it's a Viking
it's
character.
It's true.
I mean, let's be honest.
Can you still read it?
Kinda.
Cool.
But in
no
that,
one helped
that's
him.
All.
In that vein, and I did ask everyone to bring their horns.
I think this one is mine.
This one's yours.
Oh, this one is mine. Yeah, sorry.
Inspired by the game, I made horn holders.
What?
For everybody. Oh, wow.
What? That's awesome.
So there's one for.
Are these to hold our horns?
These are to hold your horns.
My God.
Horn holders?
Yeah.
My God. You're working on metalworking right now, is that correct?
I am.
How's that going? Clearly well.
So this one is for the two of you.
Oh, it's a couple's horn holder.
Yep. Okay. It's in hers.
And after you're married for 16 years, you each get your own. You just separated a little. Not by
that's
mouth.
Awesome. Look,
yeah, these are all hand twisted steel.
Awesome.
I got some hand twisted steel too.
That's awesome.
All right, now drink more beer.
That's really cool. Thanks,
thank
Nick.
You.
That's awesome. Thank you.
That's awesome.
Very cool.
Hope everyone likes them. Because I remember what the problem was with everyone holding.
Yeah, we all
right?
just had
yeah,
the
horns.
My son has been like, "Can I please use the? Can I use it, please?" I'm like, "No, you're gonna now. There's no excuse." I'm like, "Okay,
right,
you've got the holder."
It works really well.
Yeah, it does. Super that's good. Awesome.
And if anyone wishes to christen it, I also brought a bottle of mead.
Yeah.
Wait, because this went so well for me last time.
That looks like the meadery that we went to.
Isn't it?
Is this from Colorado?
It's Redstone Meadery.
So close. It looks like
looks
we went to
similar.
One in Boulder, but it's not.
Ooh.
You can't drink it.
I know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're nope. Not allowed.
Not allowed. I was watching the tape last time, like, oh, and I get a little buzzed here.
Thanks, man.
I spilt it on, no. So.
Thank you.
We also have a new thing for Yarly. The way that it works is if you want to give San points back to the players, you can do the, is it a good boy Yarly? Is that what we called it, or?
What? Oh, Yarly is here now. Yeah, you missed that.
There's no command for it. They just go to the donations page.
Okay. But anyway, you can do, I think it's a little bit higher. You can do 5 points for $4 instead of doing the individual points. So that's the other thing we added. So far tonight, we've had a few people subscribe. I don't have my glasses on.
Time Turtle 135 followed us. BSB Care, thank you for the donation. And Razlak, thank you for the resubscription.
Woohoo!
Yeah.
Times three.
X3.
And then everyone else, Dom, was that from earlier today?
Or is that a...
Okay, so Dig Byam, thank you for the follow. Bob Hay, thank you for the follow. Frost X Vane, thank you for the follow. Night Steeds, thank you for the donation. Texas Tempest, Crash Pike 22, thank you guys for the follow. And Forsaken, thank you for the donation. We haven't even started the game yet, and already everybody's being awesome.
Awesome, thanks guys.
Woo-hoo. All right, so let's recap real quickly and Jordan, since you wrote the recap, I'm going to ask you, can you mind recap what happened last time?
Recap what happened last time.
Yes.
Okay, so Talene was here as a guest player.
Right, and she had
played
a
nun.
Mm-hmm.
Was she English?
She was
Irish
nun who was defending a holy relic, which was the finger of Saint
somebody.
With a golden ring on its finger. And the Vikings came and raided her abbey, so she swallowed the finger with the ring on it. But then she threw it up on the ship.
The Vikings she was talking about.
But the ring didn't
come
back up. It was just the finger.
Right, just the finger.
So.
The Viking, but remember the Vikings that she described were
they
like,
had gills. She described them as having gills. And meanwhile, back in the village, Bragi, our village scald, was attacked by a bear who was after his, was it a 3-day old boar's head? Was that
It was a 2-day goat's head.
2-day goat's head, I'm sorry. We made many jokes about heads and days. 2-day old goat's head, so it attacked him in his home, and he was aided by, did you come by? You found
after stabbing someone, she was on the
right,
road.
Right, okay, so Talene's...
That was her fault.
Talene's character washed overboard on the boat. She wound up on the shores of Stavanger.
She stabbed Groa.
Yeah. It was your mentor.
She, like, put her arm in
your healing
in
mentor.
She helped you.
Right.
Right.
Inga.
Inga is now, has taken Grimur, my character, on as a apprentice mystic for the village. You had been taken ill from heart madness.
Heart madness.
From consuming too many hearts.
Yeah.
Well, especially you're mixing your species of hearts that you were eating.
Yeah.
It's kind of like drinking beer and wine. Yeah.
Exactly.
It's not good.
Exactly.
I succumbed to heart disease.
Sorry,
diseased heart.
Diseased heart. And then we encountered a advanced scouting party of the albinos that we fought in the village, but meanwhile, a separate party of guild Viking invaders was out in the woods, and Talene's character discovered them as my character was trying to chase her down and keep her from running away. There was a language barrier. Mm-hmm. And then a storm was brewing, and as flashes of lightning were going off in the bay, we saw... Birna did. She saw the outline of ships out in the bay just off Stavanger's coast. So
right. Albino ships?
Well, we don't know.
They
it was in lightning.
They were very pale, so...
Pale ships.
They're painted white. I don't know. I didn't make that. So thank you very much for that.
Yeah.
Very cool.
A lot happened.
Yeah.
Bears everywhere. This place is riddled with
bears.
Yeah,
bears.
It's really bad.
We have a problem.
Yeah.
This town's not going
to
make it.
If only we had guns.
If only.
To protect ourselves.
Right?
All right.
And our children.
We could have some Bear Grylls.
Yeah.
Whoa. You don't get to say anything, heart disease. You don't get to say anything.
That's true.
Oh, my.
I'm going to go off and drink some urine.
And with
Bear Grylls.
Well, we'd like to thank the remaining five of you that are watching.
And thanks to our corporate sponsor, 409.
Get out of here.
If you need to clean up beer fast, 409.
That's tough grease and grime every time.
Plus markers.
And also markers.
Uh-huh. All right, so you guys have seen these flashes of light. You see the ships. I'm forgetting Talene's character name, but Talene was surrounded with you, I believe, and you guys were about to be attacked when the Elder Gods looked down and said, hey, have some friends, and a bunch of people came to your aid and saved you. Yarly and Leaf was there, mm-hmm. And I believe Rickscap was there,
and I'm here.
You're
and better.
You're still in your. You've been kind of thrown up, and you hear a knock on your door.
Hello.
Open the door. You've been drunk. Or wake up.
All right. I open the door. I'm completely new.
It's Ornn. He doesn't Ornn the blood drinker, doesn't even...
It's fine, no,
yeah,
it makes
like,
sense.
Whatever. He's like, look, we've got ships coming. We don't have time for your, I'm drunk and having a hard time. Put on your gear.
All right.
And drink your concoction. We're probably going to need your help. BSB Care gives you a Berserker token.
Whoa!
All right, down the hatch!
Wait, you're gonna drink it right now?
No, he wants you to wait for the battle.
Wow.
I'm sure he does.
No.
So, no, bad.
In case
is it good? Is it bad? We don't know.
We don't know.
BSB Care does, Wes does, we don't.
Mm. All right. Cool.
Thank you.
All right, so, he says, hurry up. We gotta get ready. We don't have much time.
I'm already ready. I'm fully dressed.
Okay, now you're fully. You're just putting shit on.
You just had to put on a tunic.
You're like you're like bear cowl and cape.
Yeah, you have a bear face now that you wear, right? Didn't we skin the bear head?
And it's just bloody. So like it's just like dry blood.
Yeah.
I have my bear helmet.
Yeah.
Do I get plus anything for a bear helmet?
Six.
You get plus 10% to fashion skill.
Ooh.
So if you have to roll fashion skill, you'll be doing well.
I'm gonna do
Ooh, speaking of.
Great, now Pete is gonna say.
Yes!
Nice.
I've never been more attracted to you.
It totally goes with your eyes, I have to say.
I'm ready to fight.
Gurr.
All right.
Gurr.
So, is that a new one at the top?
No.
It's BSB Care.
Oh, no.
He donated $5.
It is a new one.
Thank you, BSB Care.
Like, that's literally just outside my range of sight. Like, woohoo. Okay.
Put on your goggles of sight plus
then
one.
Then I can't read anything.
Take them off when you need.
It's really annoying.
Get bifocals.
Of sight plus two.
That's the next step. That's next year. That's next year's birthday gift.
Ooh.
Welcome to
what a shitty birthday.
Yeah, exactly.
Aww. Hey, degrading vision. Happy birthday.
Your body slowly dying.
Yay! All right. So here's the deal. You guys, from as far off as they are, you think you probably have maybe 45, maybe 45 minutes, maybe an hour and a half, depending on because the winds are kicking up and it's looking pretty choppy out there. The Jarl wants you guys to move all the women and women, children, and men who cannot fight into a secure location. Okay, basically the elderly and the two young is what they're looking
Burgermeister.
For.
Wait, is that Burgermeister Meisterburger? Is that the entirety of?
Oh, that's
there?
Awesome.
Because I can't see all of
$70.
Thank you.
Ooh. Thank you, Burgermeister Meisterburger.
I feel like that's going to go somewhere terrible.
Right? I know.
Yeah, that's...
But I hope it's great.
For you guys.
I mean, it's going to be great for them no matter what.
Yeah. So you guys are quickly...
This is so hard.
Yes, I know. Is Inga
Inga's fighting.
That's why I didn't
She's fighting?
Yeah, but she's going to help
then
as long.
Then I will help... get all of the women and children and infirm into the...
Into the
Great Hall? Is that where we're taking them?
Yeah, that's where you're taking them. And she at one point like says, you know, you'll need to stick close to me during the battle because I'm going to be helping healing, you know, help heal people. I'll try to...
Every time. It always splashes back on my face.
I'll try, you know, to keep you out of harm's way.
Oh, okay.
But I'm gonna need your help.
We did it.
Sorry.
I'm sorry that we ruined that.
Let's put this over here.
When I need a new
screen. Or I could just hold it.
Need away.
No. All right. So she goes. I'll try my best to keep you out of harm's way. I know swords are not your favorite thing.
Right. Nor knives or axes.
Well, or we'll keep you. We'll keep you out. All right.
Sharp blades of grass.
So,
have you tried the spear?
It's longer.
Heavy and unbalanced.
Yes, but it keeps them at least 2 feet away from you.
When used effectively.
So, the rest of you guys are just getting ready. You can see the ships coming. And all of the warriors are getting close to the shore.
We should blow out the torches. So they can't see us.
Good idea.
Give us surprise.
So you guys start blowing out torches?
Mm-hmm. You guys agree with me?
Well.
Wonderful.
Well, sure. we know what the village is like already, so we'll have an advantage in the dark.
True.
Yes.
All right.
My thought entirely.
Okay. So you guys start blown out. And you notice, like, every once in a while, the lightning will strike and it kind of light up everything, but you don't have any stars. It takes your eyes a little bit to get used to, you know, pitch black. Really think about that for a moment, about, you know, what it must have been like not to have, even torchlight is not very bright. It's not near, you know, what we have now. And that total darkness, to kind of give you an idea of what you'll be fighting in.
Well, is the moon out?
No, there's
a storm.
There's a storm. Okay. There's a storm of brewing. Now, the town.
Turn the torches back on?
It's too late. You've already taken all this time to turn them off. Why do you smell like heart?
Yeah, we'd have to check the breaker. I think we blew a torch fuse.
Okay. You want Dumbledore's clickers?
Yeah. First off, I'd like to thank BSB Care and Burgermeister and Meister Burger. For unlocking our event.
Oh.
Whoa.
Whoa.
What?
So soon?
Yeah.
Well, $75. Boom.
Yep. Thank you, guys. It's awesome. So, you guys are in the dark.
Thank you.
You've turned off all the light. You know, you've turned off all the torches, clicked them all off. And
it's like this, right? Like that.
That's how you click off a torch.
That's how I do it.
I'm trying really hard not to hit the table.
That's a new thing. Why are we suddenly hitting the table?
I don't know.
All the time?
Anger.
Okay.
Anger management problems. I'm on, you know, just. And you guys, the flash of light happens way out there, and you see the ships, and, you know, everybody's. You've heard stories about this guy. He's not, you know, known for his.
Pigment?
Known for. He's not an actual albino.
Everyone keeps saying that. Like, that's a...
Yeah.
Like, he's wearing paint, but I guarantee if he takes a shower, he's still very bright.
Well, probably. So the wind starts kicking up. And it flashes again, and some of the ships are way closer than they were just a few moments ago.
Wait a minute.
As if they had...
Unnaturally so?
Unnaturally so. And then behind you, you hear a huge crack of thunder. And someone turns around and says, look! And
Thor is with us!
And down the side of the mountain, you see probably 300 or 400 Vikings on skis as they're coming down the mountain towards the hill, towards your stockade, going the opposite way, you know, coming from the opposite direction that you thought. They're all the way across town, about to hit the wall. And up on the very top of the, like, of a ridge, you see somebody in these long robes that are white with, and lightning is striking around him. And he seems to be, you know, making these big grand gestures as if he's causing the storm around you. And you realize that you are in the exact wrong spot to fend off the advancing army as they are skiing down the side of the mountain.
I'm sure this is both terrifying and historically accurate, but an invading force skiing down the side of a mountain,
yep.
I cannot help but with my modern context find that hilarious. But scary, because they're moving real fast on snow, which is hard to do. And there's a lot of them.
And we've never seen skis.
Actually, you have.
Sure we have.
Vikings
sweeping decisions
skis.
About what we have seen.
Guys, Wikipedia.
I've seen skis.
Yeah, no, I'm not kidding.
Viking ski.
Yeah. Look on your character sheet has skiing
cross
as a skill.
Yeah.
Do we have the map of Stavanger?
I forgot
I can't
it.
Really, I can't really see skiing.
It's down there. It's underneath the beer stain.
Keep looking.
Oh, no, that's right. You really can't see skiing very
so
well.
I assume since we
know
that they are
sorry,
coming,
yeah.
that we have been preparing, so we would have defenses, like things that we can place, like spikes.
Well, you have your wall up and spikes and stuff, okay. Yeah.
We have a fence.
But we've also been expecting the offensive to come
from
the
water,
not from
right.
Not,
right.
not having Gandalf and an army of skiers.
We're just prepared for a bear attack. And even then, not very well.
I think that's mostly you.
So they're flanking us, essentially. They're
right.
coming in from the water but, and from the wall.
Okay.
Is there anything that we can move into place at this point in time? Like anything else that we could, that we would need to go, oh,
well,
this
you,
is here.
You could, you have two choices. You could split your forces, leave some people at the water, right? Because as the lightning is striking, these boats are coming really fast. You're realizing there's only like three or four boats. Originally, it looked like a lot more, but now you're seeing that it's a lot less and a lot of people are skiing down this mountain.
How many of us are there?
You've got a good amount. There's like 900 of you.
Oh!
There's a lot of, what, so they're coming down a mountain.
They're coming down over here.
Coming from the water, so do we even have, do we have two other sides that don't have people coming at us right now, basically?
You're getting people from like the north side where the mountain is, and then you have people coming from kind of the northeast where the east side where the dock is.
But the town is walled except for the ocean.
Yes, absolutely.
But there's nowhere where we could evacuate people who can't fight, basically, is what I'm asking.
Well,
I guess.
They're in the Great Hall.
We've locked them in.
The only door out is to the north, but there are places where you can sneak out through the other wall as well.
Okay. Good to know.
So it's not, they do have ways to get out.
Okay.
Can we evenly divide our forces? 450 to the wall, 450 to the sea.
That's up to you guys. You have literally five.
Isn't it up to the Jarl?
On the
I'm
ships.
Letting you guys make the decision because you're playing.
Well, the Jarl trusts me.
Right. On the ships, what would be a standard complement that we would know?
Well, you figured there'd be the size of them.
Ships.
There's only three ships. They probably could have like, I'm going to guess like 20 people, 25 people on the longboats. Maybe, well, probably more. Like, they could probably get up to like 40 or something. I'd have to look it up. But let's say 35. Let's just say 35 a ship.
So we're looking at about more than about 100, 110 people coming in on the boat.
Right.
Versus the hundreds that are skiing down the mountain towards us.
Okay.
We need to get archers on either end.
Well, lucky that you say that. Vikings aren't really known for their archers, but BSB Care did donate for a archer as a good guy. So you guys do have an archer. It's just up to you where you guys want to put them.
One?
On the one ski archer. Side?
One archer. I think
we've plundered one archer.
Yeah. Ski side, I guess.
He's
shoot over the wall.
Yeah. Woohoo, Texas Devin, thank you for the reroll.
What? Texas Devin?
No!
Yay.
No!
That's
we
cool.
have 300 skiing Vikings coming at us.
And a Gandalf.
That's cool. We got four pushes. Four pushes.
Okay. So let's send Jeff the Archer to the wall.
Jeff the Archer. Actually, it's a Furfa. Yeah.
Furfa?
Furfa.
We call him Jeff, though, for short. Furfa's hard to say.
Furfa.
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 Virva.
Virva.
Virva,
and then
Virva
just laid in
Barkington. Ah, Virva. Okay, cool.
Virva.
Excellent.
She's finished, so it's close.
Was she an archer?
Well, she's finished, so yes.
Okay.
So she's a crossover character.
No, though, didn't we just... Never mind.
he was rogue.
Well, Atuska.
I'm sorry, Atuska.
Virva.
Still confused.
What the...
Okay. So we'll send it to the wall.
It's very NPC.
Well,
my Viking social warrior justices.
Usually I'm the one that fucks up. Thanks.
No problem. Happy to help. How do we defend our wall if we don't have archers? Like, what is our...
You get in front of the wall and you kill people.
That seems like the opposite of what you would do with a wall.
I mean, we want to protect the wall, so we make a human wall. A meat wall, if you will.
We probably also have rocks, right?
That yes.
We could, I mean, it's a very rocky area.
Many
have,
rocks.
Have we mounted rocks at the top of
light
the
them on fire.
Sure.
The rocks? Do we have?
Yeah, light some rocks on fire.
No.
How many Gandalfs do we have?
You don't have any Gandalfs.
God damn it.
You are. You're the closest thing.
Oh, no.
Saruman. How many of those do we have?
Saruman?
Yeah.
We have none.
We have no Saruman's.
What about the brown wizard? What was his name?
Radagast.
Fluffy? Fluffy the brown?
That was it.
Let's not go into all that lore. All right, so you've got Vikings coming down the mountains. You've got ships that are getting closer and closer by the second. Which way do you want to go? Do you want to send half your forces to the wall to wait for them to...
More than half,
yeah,
probably.
Yeah, because if we do half and half, then we're definitely going to take on one.
Well, I think probably 200 to the boats.
Let's do 250.
So I
bet each of them fights like two men.
Can I get a pencil? Then 250.
We still want to outnumber them.
Yes, exactly.
Do we have if we have a marker that I can use on this...
There's a dry erase.
Nope.
These look like...
Don't do that.
Don't do that. That doesn't
can
look...
Can use these?
Thank you.
You got all the colors.
No bueno. Oh my god, so, are we using a battle map on Black Bag?
We are!
Wow. I didn't bring a mini!
It's unprecedented.
You guys!
Dom, it's okay.
Oh god, oh god,
the axe.
Oh god! He's smoking!
We've broken Dom.
We've broken Dom.
All
right.
Die, die!
He's the archer!
I shall be...
Yeah, wait a minute.
This Reese's ball.
So if this...
Man, I'm a Viking character
at
home.
The Black Bag.
Oh!
Titular line.
Tittler.
Tittler? It's the Tittler line.
All right.
Wait, do we need figures?
No, not really.
No, I think he just wants to...
I just want to let you guys know what's going on.
Is this a boulder?
No, that's me.
That's the rock that Ben's going to throw. All right, so...
Here! What? With the heart madness.
All right, the heart madness. This is the docks, my bad docks.
Okay.
Luckily, this is where the Vikings are coming from. The ships are the coins. This is where the innocent are. Put the eye.
So the Vikings of Vale are coming down from the sun?
Yes, absolutely. Okay. All right.
But like
they're Viking bunnies.
Now, one thing that you guys do have
Viking
here, like
bunnies.
Spikes that stick up from the wall. So it's not just like a wall.
That's not a good plan on their part then. They're going to ski right into those spikes.
Well, they do this little side thing.
Oh, damn it, they're good.
And they slide up right to it, and then
man,
they stop.
That's so cool.
But not all
they're
of them
seniors.
Can be that good.
Ooh. I mean,
And it's got
they
a kind of the...
blast us.
Oh. It's kind of got the what was the kill the rabbit look to it? Like
the
yeah. They, you know, come down.
The ones that got me so big?
What?
No. Never those.
Not those.
Different Valkyries.
Okay, so skiing Vikings never. Coming in
so
this way.
So I did think... is that a new one?
Nope.
Meister Burger Burger Meister.
Okay. So I did thank Texas Devin for that last one. Okay.
Wait, what
is... He gave him a reroll.
Yeah. A reroll.
No!
So here's the setup.
Okay.
All of
He's
you guys... All of you guys are down here at this point.
Yeah.
So... Who's going where? Do you guys want to stick together and go to the wall? Is that the plan, or do you want to stay?
We need leaders on each front.
We do.
You should go somewhere, and I should go somewhere.
Yes. That sounds good.
Okay.
Where would you like to go?
I'll take the wall.
I will take the sea.
To the wall!
Inga? where are we needed?
Well, let's see. You're going where?
To the wall.
You're going to the wall? You're going to the sea?
Sea.
I guess we'll stick by the sea then.
It seems like they might be in more immediate danger.
Maybe.
What's that supposed to mean?
Wait, why did you say maybe like that? Inga, what do you know?
Who knows? I mean, the boats might be full of you know, bloodthirsty Vikings as well.
Well... Isn't that the assumption?
You'll be fine.
Okay.
You'll be fine. It's okay. It's okay.
Just stick close to me.
Grab your hunting spears. We'll hold them at the wall.
So a big group of people go towards the wall. You're leaving about 200 people?
I think we're set about 250.
Okay.
To repel the boats and
wait,
the rest.
Wait, let's cover ourselves in sea rocks.
All right.
Your ideas have been good so far, so...
We'll bury ourselves in sea rocks.
250 and then what to the...
The remainder. 650?
650, yeah.
Yeah.
That's math.
That's math.
That is math. That is good, solid math.
You will need it later on in life when you're repelling Viking skiers.
I
He's
believe...
winking, you just can't tell.
3. It's not just a magic number.
Okay, so you guys split off, and as you're heading towards the wall, you distinctly hear somebody in your house. Things are getting bashed around like someone's throwing your...
It's another goddamn bear.
It's always a bear.
Do you just let it go?
No, I have not. I can't lose another goat head.
Okay.
What do you keep in your house?
To the wall. And then I'm gonna run off to the.
Okay. So as you guys are passing by the house, he runs up to his thing.
You have 650 Vikings with you. If it is a bear, you could easily fight it off with 650.
I've single-handedly killed a bear. I'm not afraid of a bear.
I've never single-handedly killed a bear.
That's true.
In fairness, it was a crit as it was running away, but it counts.
So Birna is leading the rest of the Vikings to the wall?
Yes.
And then you're peeling off to check out, like, hey, who's
ransacking my house?
Okay, all right. All right, so. You guys are standing by the shore and everybody has left. I'll get back to you.
I mean, we should prepare.
Personal isn't the same as important.
Don't look at her, I'm the one that's at the seashore.
We should prepare.
I don't know.
I'm suggesting like getting close to the ground where they can't, like pretend we're also sea rocks. It's a rocky shore. Right?
This is our usual strategy.
The depth of the actual, because longboats don't actually go very deep into the water, so the
pick them off as they come in.
The boats that you guys have are pretty close to. It's shallow, really far out. The shelf isn't for a ways. And as you guys like hunker down and you're waiting for these ships, some of the ships stop moving at a certain point. It's like they just stop and they're way out there. Just kind of off where it's not incredibly deep yet, but they haven't come fully in, they just anchor.
Inga, is it possible that that figure up there is actually creating this weather?
Yes.
What can we do to stop him?
Kill him.
Surely there has to be something else we can do to counteract.
I'm a healer, not a wizard.
Balls.
Are you saying that we should send a party up there?
Of three men and two red shirts?
Can I make an occult roll to see if I have any idea what it is he might be doing?
Sure.
So we didn't talk about how much to lower my occult roll, so can I just make it an 80 for the purposes of this?
Sure.
Okay, I nailed it.
Wow.
Why do you have to lower your color?
Because you're not allowed to have a 99.
Yeah, 99's a bit high.
Did you give yourself a 99?
I can't do many other things.
All we can do is tell you what's going on and run.
And speak French.
Oui.
And I know a lot about history and reading.
Parlez-vous français?
All right, so basically you've heard of wizards that are able to call forth great... great storms.
Okay.
But you're also concerned that he might be trying to summon some god from across the realms.
Oh shit.
From one of the other worlds.
Okay.
Maybe something, you know, hideous and possibly a ice a frost giant of some sort or something like that.
Okay.
So that's your fear. All right, big crack of lightning. You guys are hunkered down. They're talking, and you suddenly see the tops of heads in the water, and then it goes completely black. And there's lots of them.
Lots of them.
We forgot to tell you they can breathe water.
Sorry.
Bye.
What?
Oh no. These are the invaders with gills that the pale woman was speaking about.
What are you talking about?
Oh my gosh, your heart madness. You didn't experience it.
No.
We saw strangers, invaders with gills like fish. It appears they can breathe beneath the waves.
Abominations.
We've no idea how many of them could be coming.
Do we have any torch oil?
You just put out all the torches.
No. But how do we light them?
You can just relight the torches.
No, he wants to know where the torch oil is.
Oh. You have some. Like, not like a ton. Are you want to put it in the water and light it?
I want to Valdez this.
Okay.
Exxon style.
I don't know if you have that much torch oil. Give me a luck roll.
Can I assist?
No.
Damn.
There's my luck.
It's up at the top. It's
under the beer.
It's one of the non-beer
things. Is it one of the non-beer things? No! I can push it. No, I can't push. Can I push a lot?
You can, but if you miss it, it's really bad.
What's your luck?
You light yourself on fire.
Oh, wait. Oh, yeah, yeah.
50, I rolled an 82.
I say push your luck, man.
It's a 50-50 chance.
This seems like this could be useful. 50 exactly!
Push in your luck!
So, yes, there is five barrels of oil just randomly sitting somewhere where a child can set them on fire and explode things.
Quickly. See those barrels of oil?
Yes.
You take one. Okay, you don't take one. Can you make fire?
Yes, of course.
All right. I need two burly men.
I can actually move a barrel.
Oh, okay.
No. I need two burly men.
Okay.
Okay.
You two, take those two barrels. Go to the far edge. You go to the middle edge. I will go to this edge. We will all open them together. And then you.
Yes?
Light it up.
From where?
From the closest point to you.
Oh, okay.
Once we do it. All right, break. Go!
Their mouths have burrowed shut.
So everyone's rolling barrels different ways, right?
I pop a hole and pouring into.
Right, and the people are coming out of the water, mm-hmm. and there's probably at least 350 mm-hmm. of them. There's a lot.
Are they coated in oil?
Not yet. You're going to your to find out what's in.
Yeah.
And you are just about to open the door when you're...
Oh, who's in there?
When your ex-wife throws the door open.
The other bear.
Didn't even know.
Yeah.
My ex-wife. Okay.
What's her name?
Chelsea.
Ayaga.
Ayaga.
That's good too.
Well, she's Chelsea. Swinging a sword at you.
Hannah.
I've had enough. She's attacking you.
Ayaga, no, wait, Ayaga!
I've had enough.
I know I'm an ass, but look!
You haven't been home to see your son in 2 years.
I'm working!
I don't want to hear it. You missed his birthdays, both of them.
I sent gifts!
They didn't get there.
It's because the forehead got eaten by...
I was carrying it.
She swings her sword at you.
I know how much Bjorn loves.
What is that?
Go ahead.
37? And hits unless you dodge.
57.
Okay, she misses. What do you want to do?
Ayaga, calm yourself. This isn't the time. You're right. I'm a heel. But look, we're being invaded.
I've seen skiing Vikings before.
We've all seen that. It's easy.
That's
we've done it ourselves.
Not the Vikings, Gandalf.
That is impressive.
Which is our word for mystic.
This
Give
is
me
our
a persuade roll.
It's our word.
This
our
village's word for mystic.
Specifically,
Lommel. Lommel.
We call him a Gandalf.
60.
How persuasive are you?
No.
She swings 45. Her sword at you.
Oh, no.
What's that?
61.
Okay, misses.
It's a 90.
It's a 91.
Oh, 91.
Different dice.
Yeah, ones that hit you more, right?
Oh, no, keep those dice.
You're saying get different
Do you want to disengage and run away?
60s.
And just let her do her thing, or do you want to try to keep her from hitting you? What do you want to do?
Listen.
Broggy will, I'm gonna grapple her. I'm gonna try and knock the sword from her hand.
Okay.
Let's see. There's no time.
Just don't cut her arm off.
Yeah, like this one did.
Don't crit fail.
Got that.
55. What am I doing that after? Brawl. Okay. Fighting brawl. I know I had it in here. No, missed by 5.
Ah.
So you try to grab her. She's going to dodge, so let's see how bad or good.
It's an 81.
So.
Your ex-wife sucks.
In trying to.
Hey,
in trying to. move out of the way. You guys actually hit each other and kind of fall into the thoroughfare. There's you know, mud all around, all this, you know, all this rain and wind. She goes, "You have to be a better father." And she takes her elbow and tries to get you in the face.
Ayaga, you're right. But today is our chance for glory. And if I'm still alive, then we can have this conversation afterwards. But if not, then I will go to Valhalla knowing that I am a lousy father.
Inspired.
And sad.
Fine, go to Valhalla. I get the goat's head, and she sits up and she walks away.
Fine!
She walks back into your house, takes the goat's head, and walks out the back.
She literally got your
This
goat.
Is your son!
She got my goat.
And that's where we say
That's right. Yeah. This is historically accurate, everyone. Historically accurate.
Yep.
All right.
Altering the past.
That's how this works.
It's all kind right. of like we're just going to Wikipedia and putting our own red links in.
We also invented Gandalf.
Totally did. All right. So you get up and you realize as you're, because you're on a hill, because it goes up. If you guys remember when you were looking for the Jarl's son, it kind of went up into the mountains a bit. Yeah. So you can see down to the dock. And in the dock, a flash of lightning happens and you see flame go across the bay. And, right? And when it happens, you notice that there are a bunch of bodies. You can't make out much because it's hectic, but there are a bunch of people in the water coming up, a lot, like 350, like a mass of people. Mm. And a lot of them now are on fire and they're dipping down into the water and freaking out. And then on this side, you see that the Viking skiers have reached the bottom. And of course they click out of their ski things. And are you guys behind the wall, or do you go
We're
around?
We're behind the wall. What I actually want
And you're actually up over here.
Oh, we're over here?
Yeah.
Because
oh. that's the dock.
What I want to be able to do is take one of those other barrels of oil and basically get rocks and then light them on fire and throw them over.
So you want to throw flaming rocks over it. Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Wait.
Also that one archer.
They're going to roll down the hill and burn down the fence, but... By all means, Brogy isn't smart enough to tell you that.
Well, I don't think the hill, there's got to be like a little bit of flat area.
Yeah,
like,
there
can't
is.
Be. Because
yeah,
they stopped their skis.
Yeah, they.
Coolly.
Right.
The hill stops like where the map is, begins kind of thing, way back there. And they stop, they take their skis, they just, get out of their skis, and then they run towards the wall.
So 80s.
Kind of, yeah.
We're going to call you Davinger. Is that all right? Davinger.
So what do you guys want to do? So you're getting the oil.
Yeah, I want to basically create, like, if we put the oil here, and then I want to have some other people gathering rocks and bringing them in, and then other people are picking up those rocks, dipping them in the oil, lighting them on fire, throwing. So there's sort of this whole, like, just a bunch of people working together.
A lot of people's hands getting caught on fire.
No, this is a thing we do a lot, so they have myths.
They understand. And also the archer would probably be doing this as well with the boat, with the arrows.
Okay, so are you still going to go to the wall, or are you going to go back down to the...
I'm going to run over to you, since you seem to be in charge of the wall, and say, there are more men down by the boats! It was it's the abominations. More are coming than were on the ships.
Okay, well, I think this is going pretty well. Why don't we take a few and head back over to the docks and try and see if they need help.
Okay, so you guys are gonna peel off and go
you.
Back.
Yeah, we'll take like...
three guys.
Yeah,
so
three people with us.
Wait, the fire's the fire's going well, but what happens is it just pushes them farther out and they have to come up onto the beach and then come around the
we've
fire.
Ah, we've made a choke point.
And they're coming around this side on both.
Oh, so, around, all the way around the walls?
No, to where the dock is. Yeah, yeah, right there.
Yeah, we've made a choke point, so.
Yeah.
Two choke points.
Mm-hmm. And they're running towards you guys.
Shield wall?
Shield wall.
Shield wall.
Shield wall.
Okay. So you guys get a shield wall ready.
Two shield walls.
One here.
One for each of the two. Mm-hmm.
And do we know as Vikings, I've only watched one episode, that we can make a shield wall and like start poking through, like, Roman centurions.
Well, according to the TV show, yes. Yeah.
So they do know how to do that.
Yeah.
They don't. The Viking shields are not really. They do that, but the Viking shields are not as strong as the Roman shields.
They're also round, so they're not big square shields.
Yeah.
It looks really weird when they make a huddle. It kind of looks like a.
I almost posted that today.
I don't know, like a carnival thing. And it's hard to describe.
But I would think, yeah, especially with how many bears there are here, that
there are lots of bears.
The people of Stavanger would know and be proficient in the use of spears. That we have a lot of them around.
Yeah,
that's
you guys
how you
have
hunt
spears.
Bears.
Yeah,
yeah. Well, hopefully the bears will come and help too.
Hey, bears! I know we've had our differences.
Come on, bears!
Enemy of my enemy.
You've had some fun, we've had some fun, but come on.
Summon
no one likes
bears.
Kill people.
Right? Bears love to
nobody
eat
likes.
Fish.
Did you have that spell?
Summon bears?
Oh, no, I don't have any spells. This is Call of Cthulhu. All
right, so...
There's barely any magic in here.
So...
I've eaten enough bear hearts. Can I communicate with bears?
Nope.
That's how that works.
Speak with bears.
No, I cannot speak with bears.